Jamie Lenman, why did Reuben split up?
Why did Reuben split up? You can't bring me all the way here.
I've ambushed Jamie Lenman with this question.
Well, the thing is, like, all bands have got to split up, haven't they?
At some point.
From my mind, like, all the best bands that I could think of, apart, there's a few exceptions, like maybe the Beatles and Madness and whatever, three albums and then fuck off, you know?
Right.
And the kind of band we were, you know, we used all the energy, and that's the sort of band that it was. And so if it had carried on from like 5, 6, 7 albums, this would have got boring, right?
Right.
And
I'm not agreeing, I'm just saying. Okay.
No, trust me, the fourth album that I'd written was awful.
Right.
No, I'm joking.
Were you writing a fourth record at the time?
No, well, that was one of the problems, is that like I'd sort of stopped writing, like the well had run dry a bit, because it was so difficult to just work these songs out with the other guys. We were all so exhausted and we weren't rehearsing particularly well. I mean, the big answer really is that we were just really tired.
Right.
Really tired. But that's what I'm saying, like, we sort of had to get to that point, because like I said earlier, it's only good if you've had to work hard for it, right? So of course we were tired, because we put all our energy into those three records and 10 years of touring. So it was sort of, that was what I always thought was going to happen, really.
Was there a moment where you went, all right, and what was that moment?
It had been coming for a long time, because it was always very hard, and I know we've got a bit of a reputation for banging on about how hard it is being in a band, but I think, you know, you've got to be truthful, haven't you? A lot of bands try to go, oh, look, we're in a champagne bath and a golden Royals Voice and all this stuff.
Yeah.
And it's never true.
Cornish pasties and a badly painted wall backstage, isn't it?
Exactly. And so it was always tough. And so right after the first record, I thought, man, this is harder than I thought it was going to be. So right from there, really, from after the first record, I thought, how long do I want to keep doing this, really? And I can't remember what the death blow was. Well, I can. It was because this particular festival kept asking us to play, and I just couldn't say yes because I couldn't face going on the stage. And the money kept going up and up and up because they thought we were playing hardball.
Right.
Whereas we weren't. Like, I couldn't bring myself to put that guitar around my neck. And then when the money got to such a stupid amount, and I thought, am I really going to say no to all this money for like an hour of singing these songs? And I realised that if it was so difficult, I should probably stop. We just couldn't carry on anyway.
Was it Reading?
No, it weren't fucking Reading.
what? Glastonbury?
No, it weren't Glastonbury.
Which one was it?
I'm not going to tell you.
Oh, man,
Reading,
that's brutal.
Reading never asked us. Reading
never asked us. Fucking. I'm allowed to say that. This is my independent thing.
Sure.
And so, final question is, did you get a bit pissed off when, like, you were like, all right, we're split up, no farewell tour. No farewell tour, what was that about? Let's do that as well.
Well, I told you this on the radio show we did, but I'll reiterate it for the fans.
People didn't listen to that.
Another thing, isn't it? Because like Reuben was like it was a real band.
Yeah.
Like, it wasn't like this pretend thing we were doing. You know, the lyrics I wrote were about me. They were basically my diary, and we didn't put any special clothes on to go on stage. So it was just us. And those bands who say, like, okay, we're splitting up and we're going to do a farewell tour, I just think it can't really have been your whole heart, can it? Because to go back, that's like splitting up with your wife after 10 years, but like going on one final holiday together.
No, fair enough.
That would be awful, wouldn't it? Because the only reason you're splitting up, the only reason you're getting rid of that band, is because you can't physically, like I said, you can't physically do it, play another note. I couldn't, at the time we split up, I couldn't be in the same room as the other two, you know? So how could we...
Yeah, fair enough.
And people are saying, oh, you know, I've got this, do you want to come to this gig and there's going to be a couple of instruments, do you want to do a song? And I'm like, if we could do a song, we could have just done another record. There couldn't be any more. So that's why there was no farewell tour, because we couldn't, it was just impossible.
And was it well annoying when you kind of come across as like being the biggest band in the world after you split up? Everyone I know was bummed out about it, and it was like, well, I don't remember seeing you at the fucking shows.
Terry, I have to say, I do think that sometimes. I do think, where were you at the shows? But do you know what? Whenever I think that, I remember that a lot of this has to do with the internet. And the internet and music were sort of beginning to do that at the time that band was around. And sort of when we split up, or whatever you want to call it, it still hadn't really got to the place it is now, where it's intertwined and the internet is this whole thing. Mm. And, you know, Facebook hadn't really happened at that point. We had MySpace, but fuck's sake.
Yeah, exactly.
But the thing is, when you look on those online forums, and you look, when you see when people saying, oh, I love Reuben and they're the biggest band, if it's people on the internet, it's probably only about five people just typing it again and again and again. Mm. And the internet does that thing where it makes a whisper sound like a roar.
Fair enough.
And so if you're getting your info from there, which, you know, is the easiest place to get it, it does sound like there's this huge support for that band, which wasn't represented in album sales or ticket sales. But I think in reality, it's just the same dedicated love of a few individuals magnified through that lens. So I don't think there really is that much more support than there was. And I'd like to add, for anyone watching this, I'm very grateful for that support, and I was at the time, and I still am, and I was grateful even when I wasn't making music. I was aware of it and grateful. So yeah, I think that's the internet that does that.
So that's why we're open Split Up. Subscribe to the channel down here. Jamie Lenman. Cheers.
You bastard.